literally read a poem, I don't know how to commit to memory like Drea and TJ. I'm of the old school where you read poetry. It's called African Hair. The roots of our history are planted in our hair. The big, bold uproars of the 70s, strong, powerful, confident, greeting the sky like a clenched fist, defiant in their stride, bobbing from side to side.
Is it?
Yeah.
Great. What is that one about?
Well, it's a project that that I did, where I thought, you know, some of our writers in Botswana write in English, but we are saying we want to write in an English that will place us geographically and language-wise, culture-wise, in Botswana rather than in England. So obviously our English would have to be different. It would have to be an English that is specifically rooted in our culture and traditions. It sounds like a contradiction, because one of the most important things in a culture in terms of expression is language. The first project is the Setswana Riddles translated into English. The next one, which I've almost completed, is the proverbs, Setswana proverbs translated into English. And by incorporating these proverbs from Setswana and riddles and idioms and so on, you are not only making the English language richer, but you're also internationalizing, Tswana philosophy, which is embedded in the proverbs and the riddles.
Must be difficult, but sometimes it's hard to translate proverbs to another language. There's a risk of losing the original meaning.
Oh yes, yes. It's not easy at all. The way that I've found is to, you know, go for the literal translation without making the proverb seem ridiculous, you know. It's a struggle, but it works.